phrase.
Good morning, Marshall.
Well, I think we have just what you're looking for. We always get a good haul over the 4th of July.
Good. Come on, let's go.
Here she comes, Bill.
Once you come in, we'll see what we've got.
Wait a minute, I forgot my tape recorder.
Boys, this is Miss Martha Jeffries.
How do you do?
Our uncle owns a radio station here in town, KGRK. She's been doing a roving reporter program. Maybe some of you have been listening to it, A Face in the Crowd. And a mighty nice little program it is, too. Now, I know this is a little unusual, but this morning she's going to do our program from right in here. So, Miss Jeffries, the jail of Tommy Hawk County is at your disposal.
That's very simple. Look, we just talk into this little microphone in a natural voice. You know, we just sort of chat back and forth. Now, look, it's completely informal. So, well, if anybody wants to sing a song or tell an anecdote or funny story,
let me see now. Hey, Beanie, last time you were in here, seems to me I heard you singing something.
I ain't got my teeth with me this time.
This is Radio KGRK, the voice of Northeast Arkansas, bringing you its morning feature, A Face in the Crowd. Whose face? Well, it could be yours. Or yours, or yours, because people are fascinating wherever you find them. This is Marsha Jeffries looking for more faces in the crowd, this time from the Tommy Hawk County Jail. Okay, say something.
Don't worry, Ma. Everything's fine. Nicest jail I've been in this part of the country. Oops, 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 oops.
Hey, you can do something.
Just because I got black skin, I ain't no minstrel, man.
I'm sorry, Miss Jeffries, but they're just an honorary bunch. Say, where's the drunk we taken in last night with the guitar? What's his name?
Rhodes. That's him lying over there in the...
Well, go over there and wake him up.
Better watch him, he's mean.
Miss Jeffries, would like to speak with him. You wake him up.
Hey, wake up!
Good morning, Mr. Rhodes. I'm from Radio KGRK.
Get away! Get away!
Sheriff's here.
I don't care if President of the United States is here. Man can't get a little decent sleep in jail.
Who are you?
Well, I'd like to introduce you to our radio audience and have you
radio?
Sing a song and spin a yarn. Join me a little back
talking
about it.
Wait a minute. We're racing your motor. What do I get out of this? I mean, Mr. Me, Myself, and I.
Sheriff?
What's he in here for?
A week. Drunk and disorderly.
Well, I think if you'd cooperate, I might see my way clear to let you out of here the first thing in the morning.
Me too, Sheriff. I'm his manager.
Well, boys in here says you don't keep your word any too good.
Well, you live up to your end of the bargain, and I'll live up to mine.
Well, okay. It's a deal. Tomorrow morning, I'll sing you a song.
When I went east to Sarah Lawrence, that's a college, I majored in music. And I learned that the real American music comes from the bottom up. When George Gershwin played it in New York, it was black tie music. But the real beginning of it was from folks who never owned a tie. Now, I just bumped into a fella you never heard of, name of Rhodes. Hey, what's your first name?
Jack or Mac, what's the difference?
Calls himself Lonesome Rhodes.
Lonesome? Hey! Hey, now, don't be rushing me. Cut that thing off a minute. Give me a chance to lubricate my Adam's apple. Ah. Like a little snake medicine to put you in the mood. Ain't Mama a beauty? Oh, a guitar beats a woman every time. You know I never have seen a woman I could trust like this old guitar. Love my mama guitar. She's always there waiting for me to pick her up and hold her. Never asks me for money or goes cheating around when I ain't looking. And if she gets a little sour, why, I just give her a little twist like so and we're right back in tune together.
Hey, Lonesome, sing Rye Whiskey.
Lonesome.
Hallelujah, I'm a bum.
Oh, she can see that plain enough. You know, ma'am, well, there were a bunch of fellas like us, outcasts, hobos, nobodies, gentlemen loafers, one-time or all-time losers, call us what you want to. Whenever we get together, we tell our funny stories. Me and Beanie and the rest of these hand-to-mouth tumbleweed boys like you see in here. If whiskey don't get us, then women must. And it looks like I'm never gonna cease my wandering. But deep down, when we get ready to tuck our heads under our wings and go to sleep, we ain't kidding ourselves. We're so low down lonely, the fella we couldn't stand the sight of this morning. Tonight, when the guards get ready to douse the lights and plunge us into darkness, why, that same fella seems like our nearest, dearest buddy. 10,000 miles away from home. No, I ain't crying, because I'm going to be a free man in the morning. You hear that, fellas? A free man! The sheriff's going to open up his cage, and I'm going to be as free as a bird in the morning. Hey, maybe I can try putting a couple of rhymes together.
Sing something dependable like Home on the Range.
I ain't going to sing no Home on the Range. No, sir, not if it means I rot in here another month. I'm going to sing what I'm going to be. A free man in the morning. Oh, good night, moon. Moon, you just fade, 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 fade away. Oh, good night, moon. Moon, you just fade away. And hurry up, Mr. Sun. Bring on. Oh, bring on the sheriff with his great big old key. Yeah, bring on old Big Jeff, the sheriff of Piggott, Arkansas, with his great big old fat key. To open up his nasty, filthy jailhouse and make a free man of me. How about that, Lou Ellen? You got any objection to being a free man in the morning?
No, sir, I ain't.
Gonna be a free man in the morning. Free man in the morning. Free man in the morning. Oh, know the reason. All right, I'm ready as I'll ever be.
Thank you, Lonesome Rhodes. That was just fine.
You mean tell me you had that thing going all the time?
I'm a sneaky type.
Well, chop me up and sit.
You like him?
Yes, sir. By golly, Marsh, I think you got yourself quite a fella there.
Yeah,
quite a fella.
I sure would like to use him on our early bird show from 7 to 8. Would you let me do that, Uncle J.B.?
Number, please, Mr. Chairman.
Hello. Get me the jail, Gladys.
The jail?
That's right, the sheriff. Or should I say our future mayor. You know, that boy may be bashful, Marsha, but he's pretty sweet on you.
Listen, the only thing I'm interested in right now is running the best radio program in Northeast Arkansas.
Hello, Big Jeff.
Rhodes?
Yeah?
Well, that was the agreement, J.B. I was only holding him on a drunk and disorderly.
I guess you got no idea which way he was headed.
Well, there's only two ways out of this town. I can hardly see him going west.
Because he just come from jail over in West Pickett. You'll likely find him on the East Road.
Let's go after him. There he is.
Hey! Hi! Morning!
We've been looking for you.
Yeah?
What for?
Listen, this is my uncle, Mr. Jeffries, who owns our radio station.
Well, how's it feel to be a free man in the morning? Where you headed now?
Port St. Joe, Florida.
Well, that's a long walk. What's down there?
Oh, plenty of water and plenty of fishing bridges and snapper boats and tarpon rolling.
You know, I've always wanted to catch me a tarpon.
What's to stop you?
I can't afford it. I got a radio station, newspaper, printing business.
The president of the Kiwanis? I can't afford it.
Come on, Beanie.
Listen,
I ain't got but 4 or 5 days to make it to St. Joe. That's a steal somebody's car.
Now, you just wait a minute. We got a job for you. Every morning on our station, 7 to 8.
I don't want no job.
Why not?
It's too much like work, man.
You got any money?
Oh, Mom will always get me a little meal. Brains. I can sleep in a jail.
Come on, try it for a day. How about if you had a plane ticket to Florida? You put it in your pocket? If you ever want to go, you just go.
Well, okay. I'll try it for one day.
Now turn it around.
Let's go.
Marsha, take him over to the hotel and get him a room. Maybe we better clean him up a little bit.
See you around, Bing.
Get in the back.
Would you mind closing the door?
My goodness, ain't we fussy.
Look, this wardrobe you got, I think I better send it to the laundry for you.
I'll wash it out myself. That way I can cut out any time I feel like it.
So early in the morning?
How'd you like to come over here and sort of get acquainted early in the morning?
Look, we really do have to hurry.
I bet you never sat on a hotel bed with a man before, did you?
Oh, really? Look, I'll meet you downstairs.
Free man in the morning. Free man in the morning. Ladies, or I guess I should say girls, the boss lady of this year program just shoved a piece of paper at me, says I ain't got but 3 more minutes. That's what I got against working. It's all tangled up with that word hurry. You know, back in my little old town of Riddle, we had a cousin named Harry. We all called him Cousin Hurry because he was always running someplace. Till one day, he fell down a flight of steps and broke his fool neck. We put a sign on his grave, says he's in such a hurry, he just couldn't wait to get here. Shucks, I was just getting ready to add on a verse about being a free woman in the morning. I bet a whole lot of you dream about that sometimes with all them breakfast dishes piling up in the sink and them cranky husbands to get off to work. Ain't it a shame the way they get on you about every little old thing just because they ain't got gumption enough to take it out on the boss?
Well, goodbye, dear. I'm late for work.
I hate to talk against my own kind, but I never have seen a man yet could appreciate how hard you women has to work. Why, they think running a little water over a dish is all there is to it. They never see you cleaning the grease out of the sink or wiping out of the oven the beef gravy or the apple juice that sizzles over the side of the dish onto your grill.
Now, how would he ever know that? Oh, listen to this one. Dear Lonesome, though I never set eyes on you, hey, listen, I know you must be a saintly-looking man. Only a saint could understand the burdens of a housewife like you did. Well, they all say the same thing, morning, Bob. They love his voice, they love his guitar, they love his ideas. They should know some of his ideas.
You're not fooling me. You're proud of him. Let's work
well,
in my
office. Well, listen, there hasn't been a mail like this since you started the station.
Hello.
Shh.
Oh, hello, Wayne. Oh, so you like the fella, huh? Okay, I guess we can put you down for 3 1-minute spots. Thanks for calling. Goodbye.
What do you know? Advertisers actually calling in to buy time. Looks like this station's liable to make a little money yet.
Go easy on that advertising, Unc. You hear me? Because I don't think he wants to stay.
Well, Marsha, you found him. Now it's your job to keep him here.
Hey,
the time, honey. Every time you see this well running dry, you just come over here and prime her again.
That's right, Lonesome. I'm afraid that's gonna be your name.
My real intimate friends call me Larry. You call me Larry, huh? It's a good chaser.
You always drink like that?
Not always. Back in Riddle, it's pretty strict. Didn't allow us to touch hard liquor till we was 10 or 11.
Is there really a town called Riddle?
Well, I'll tell you the flat truth. It's just a sort of a, what you call it, a...
composite?
Compost heaps, more like it.
Where do you come from?
Oh, from all over. Any time you can mention for 500 miles, I bet I lived in a day or two.
What'd your father do?
He was a spieler with a two-bit corner. Now, if each and every one of you will hand me up your $1 bills, I'm going to favor you with a $5 gift.
You sure loved him, didn't you?
He ran off and left us when I was knee-high to a beer barrel.
Your mother had to take care of
you? Never mind about her.
What about all those aunts and uncles you're always talking about?
Uncles? I wish I had a nickel for every time I fell asleep waiting for my old lady to come home. When I'd wake up, she'd say, "Shh, your uncle's sleeping." I'd say, "Uncle Lou?" She'd say, "No, this is your Uncle Mike or Uncle Mo." Seemed like there wasn't a town in Arkansas or Missouri I didn't have an uncle in. Yes, ma'am. My old lady sure was generous about taking in relatives.
Didn't you grow up so happy-go-lucky? Put your whole self into that laugh, don't you?
Marcia, I put my whole self into everything I do.
You mean you turned down an invite for me to go out with this tramp? Oh, are you gonna fight?
No, stop it! Stop it!
Thanks for them pies, gals. You're gonna spoil me. Well, I think I've sung at you enough for one morning, so maybe I ought to wind up with a joke. Let's see, yeah, I got one. Sheriff Big Jeff Best. You say that ain't no joke?
Well, the fact he's running for mayor strikes me as kind of funny.
Nope. Back in my little old town of Riddle, the way we elect fellas to office is we try to figure which fella can best be spared from useful labor. Like, you take village halfwit. Now, in most places, he's gonna be put on town relief. But now in Riddle, why, as economy measure, we make him the dog catcher. But now, this sheriff of yours, now, of course, I don't say nothing against him, but if you got any mutts around you want to get rid of, why don't you just take them over to his place to see if he can handle the job?
Here, Whitey. Here, Whitey.
Sway people like this.
Yeah, I guess I can.
And now an amusing example of grassroots democracy in action. It seems there's a small town radio personality called Lonesome Rhodes out in Arkansas who literally sent a mayoralty candidate to the dogs.
Larry? Larry?
Listen, I'll just plow right through and keep it going and leave the rest to me. Thanks for bringing up the breakfast, Florine.
Mr. Stein, Larry, this is Mr. Steiner. He's come all the way from Memphis to see you.
Mr. Rhodes, I'm one of the oldest theatrical agents in the Mid-South. I book a lot of acts for the grand old opera. I discovered Hank Snow and Webb Pierce. And the first morning I heard you, I said to myself, Abe Steiner, that man's got power. Not just catchy songs and funny stories, power. How would you like to come to Memphis, son?
Memphis?
Mr. Rhodes, you put me in mind of Will Rogers when he first came to Memphis. I can make you a star, boy, if you put yourself in my hands.
Shucks, mister, I'm just a country boy. I ain't even sure I want to stay in this danged old radio business.
Well, I'm not one of these high-pressure fellas. But do you mind if I call you again?
No.
Jeffrey?
Grand Ole Opry, that's the big time.
Well, it never hurt none to play hard to get. You ought to know about that.
You don't seem to be pining for lack of company.
I get extra hungry in the morning. You cold, fish, respectable girls. Inside, you crave the same thing as the rest of them.
Tell old Lonesome the truth.
You're on in 8 minutes.
Ooh, we is so hot this morning, the creek just give up. I mean, it was bone dry. So I reckon you young'uns figure they ain't got no place to swim. But my boss, old J.B. Jeffries, he's got a fine swimming pool right here in town. So why don't all you kids just go on over to his place for a ducky? J.B. will be proud to have you. Splashing in the end. That's your curly-headed little darlings enjoying J.B. Jeffries' kind of hospitality.
Mr. Rhodes.
Huh? Rose,
shh. Nellie's on the air.
Oh, that's all right. Who is it?
Hey, it's a program manager at the Memphis TV station. You said Mr. Steiner told him about you?
Why, shucks. I can talk to him right here on that. Shucks, all these folks out here are my friends. I ain't got nothing to hide from you. Yeah. Hello there, partner. What's that? You want me to come on your TV in Memphis with this kisser of mine? All I got to say is you're a brave man. $500 a week, huh? Confederate?
$500 a week?
Shh, we can do better than that. Partner, leaving Pickett's like leaving my own flesh and blood kin. Now, if I got to take leave of these good folks, why, I'd rather try it gratis, for nothing, for a couple of weeks. And if you ain't satisfied, or if I get homesick for Arkansas, why, back I come and nobody gets hurt. But now, if we find we get along, you make it, $1,000 a week? Yeah, you get the idea. Oh, yeah, and transportation for yours truly and my little gal Friday. Not to mention Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, Marcia Jeffries.
I'm glad you're going with him. Take good care of him for me.
I'll sure try.
Take good care of yourself.
Whoa! Marcia! Come on, honey, come on, we'll be late, come on. Come on, the train will leave, come on. Whoa! Bye! Bye! Bye, Lucy! So long, Luther! You write to me now! I'll be thinking of you, good people!
Well, I'm glad to shake that gum. I was only kidding, hon. You all know me better than to believe everything I say.
Bye! Bye! Goodbye! And God bless you, good people!
Thank you.
If I'd known you were gonna put lipstick on me, I'd never come.
Now stop complaining. You look beautiful. Lonesome, this is Mel Miller. The station's assigned him as your rider.
Rider? You're gonna have the easiest job in the world, boy, because I never learned too much reading.
I'll just block out the continuity for you.
What are you, Eastern College?
No, as a matter of fact, I went to school over in Nashville. I was Vanderbilt 44.
Okay, Vanderbilt 44.
Mr. Rhodes, we're ready for you now. Hey, what are you doing to that makeup?
Relax, 10 seconds. Ready on one. Stand by two.
Just be perfectly natural, easy, and relaxed. A real country. Now, when that red light is on, that camera is on you. Yeah, put this in your mouth. I think that straw is going to be a very nice touch.
And here he is, ladies and gentlemen, a newcomer to Memphis television, but sure to become an old friend. A face in the crowd, starring that Arkansas traveler, Lonesome Rhodes.
What do you want? Howdy. You know, I've never ever seen myself on one of these things before. So if I stop and admire myself on this, what do you call it?
Monitor.
Yeah, monitor. Show the folks what I'm talking about, will you? You know, the director said all I had to do was, yeah. He said all I had to do is act like I was looking straight at you. But what he forgot to say was there'd be a great big old red eye looking straight at me. You know, that old eye does look kind of familiar, though. Reminds me of my old Uncle Abernathy after a night of drinking that fine old five-star corn liquor. He put a star on the bottle for every day it aged. If the ocean was moonshine and I was a duck, I'd dive. I got too hot a fire in my boiler to sing this morning. What's the matter with you big city fellas anyhow? Hey, don't you all ever go to bed around here? Last night I settled down for my 12-hour nap in the hotel, and moly hoses, what a honking and lights are flashing on and off and gals are giggling on the street. So I called down to the desk on this telephone like they got in every room, you know. What's going on here, I says to the clerk. It ain't New Year's Eve by any chance. Nah, he says. It's just 10 o'clock at night in Memphis. So I pulled back on my duds and I went outdoors to take a look, see what all the commotion was. Hey, Mr. Cameraman, move that old red eye a little closer.
It's only been on 2 minutes, Nora, telling us what to do.
I want to talk face to face with them friends of mine out there. Hey, which one of these holes I look in? Yeah. You know one thing I could see right off about a big city? There's a whole lot of people in trouble out there. You don't see it so much in the daytime when everybody's hustling and bustling around, rushing from where they is to where they ain't. But it's at night, you know, late at night, around 4 o'clock in the morning is what I call the dividing line. All you got left in is folks in trouble. But I want to tell you good people something happened to me this morning just before the sun is ready to come up. I'm going to tell it to you and see if it don't happen to you the same way it happened to me. And if it don't move your hearts the way I think it will, then you're just a bunch of big city pickle hearts. And I'm going to pack up my one shirt and the old Bible my daddy gave me and my cigar box guitar, and I'll just get me on home to riddle.
He's telling the truth about the one shirt, but I have yet to see the Bible.
But when he talks about walking the night, well, I couldn't write it that well.
Now, come on out here. Now, don't be scared of this thing, at least any more than I am. Where's this one?
Hey, a colored woman. Memphis, that takes nerve.
I told you, he's his own man.
Now, you just tell the folks the same thing you told me.
Well, you see, it's my house.
It burnt down. She's got 7 young'uns and ain't no insurance.
Oh, Helen, look what they're having on television now. It's about time.
So she just walked around and around because she didn't have no place else to go.
I didn't know a single living soul in Memphis.
Are you kidding?
What are you gonna bet you got 20,000 friends out there? And each one of them's ready to prove it to you by sending in a half a buck so you can get on back to Millington and build a decent house for them brasses of yours. Now, please, nobody send in more than four bids,
because you may not be able to spare it yourself. Miss Cooley, maybe you think you just...
Every part over $10, let's cut a half of that house.
Now, you've got friends, and they're going to be looking out for you. Ain't you, folks?
Yeah! Molly and Dolo.
Lonesome! You should see how the money's pouring in. They need five girls.
Young man, you graduated from sustaining. You've got a client.
What in the ever-loving world is that?
It's a mattress company. That means you get your $1,000 a week.
No, we get his shirts. Stand still, you slob.
Here. Here. Get your hand in here.
Here you go. Yeah, Yannis comes.
That sure is pretty amusing. Cigar box guitar is $18,541 of these things so far, and we ain't hardly started yet. Miss Cooley says thank you. You're good people. You folks are building a house. Ain't nothing in this world you can't do when you let the best side of you take over. Oh, I see my old clock watcher going this way. He wants me to make sure I leave time for the commercial. You didn't know I had a sponsor, did you? Neither did I. They woke me up this morning. You good looking, scoundrel, lady. What? Yeah, I got the commercial on me somewhere. Let's see, yeah. See, it's Johnny Longshot's tip for the Daily Double. No, well, that ain't it. Lonesome. Darling, you ain't forgetting your little Arkansas Annie. No, that surely ain't it. Friends, comma. Why not invest in sleep insurance, question mark. That is what you will be doing when you buy your Luffler Easy Rest mattress, period. Comes in six tasty flavors. Oh, yeah, that's our next commercial. Personally, when I'm dog tired, I can sleep on the floor. One of the best nights' sleep I ever had is in a boxcar. They say that a firm mattress is better for your spine. But now, if you're gonna follow that all the way, ain't it just better just go ahead and sleep on the floor? But if some of you soft insist on sleeping on the bed, I reckon you can do worse than a Luffler Easy Rest. End of commercial. Maybe also the end of Lonesome Road.
Seriously, I was on the phone with Mr. Luffler for half an hour. I'm sure he's seen us and he hasn't even looked around.
Thank you.
He says he's got a loophole in his contract. And if you kid his commercial once more, he's going to walk right through it.
Hey, hi, Lonesome.
How are you?
Hey.
Boy, I almost forgot. I got you a month's food ticket at the White Owl for the plug you gave him this morning.
Yeah?
Yeah, I guess you didn't know I do a little schlockmeistering on the side, huh?
Schlockmeistering?
All you gotta do is slip in a remark, innocent-like, about one of these products, and they pay off in kind. You know, a case of beer, free drinks at the Yellow Rose Cafe, all that jazz. I tell you, boy, it mounts up.
Isn't that illegal, stealing time from regular sponsors?
Illegal? Honey, nothing's illegal if they don't catch you.
See you around, Joy.
Okay, Lonesome, see you around.
Who was that?
That's Joy DePalma, Luffler's office boy.
He won't be an office boy long.
Mr. Luffler told me he don't like me to talk nasty about his mattress. Shucks, I said you could get a good night's sleep on one of them. If you're real tired. There I go again. But I just can't seem to get my mouth around some of them things they wanted me to say. Well, I'll try. And now, a message of importance. Now, you good people ain't so dumb you don't know what's important. Atom bombs important and things like that. I don't reckon a Luffler mattress will break your back, but it sure ain't no world-shaking message. Well, just in case you won't be seeing me again.
Hey, fellas.
Here's a little song to remember me by. Give me an E. Well, goodbye, Mr. Luff-Luff, and thanks for the ride. I like to have your money, but I'd rather have my pride. On these corny old commercials, we just cannot agree. So you can tell up my contract, make a free man of me. Gon' be a...
Get me my lawyer.
Yeah. Who is it?
It's me, Lawson. Larry. Thought I'd say goodbye.
Just a minute.
Just thought I'd tell you I'm hitting out. I'm gonna hit the road.
Well,
wait till. Oh, what's the difference? So, Mr. Luffler, he wants to fire me unless I promise to show him my scripts in advance. There ain't no scripts. It's just me. Was me.
Stay, even on suspension. Nah. What'd you do for Miss Cooley?
I'm not my brother's keeper.
It's just that you are and you don't know it.
Nah, I don't count out of no mattress company. See you in jail sometime. We shook him up a little bit. Had a ride for our money.
Larry. You come here.
Fish, Marshy? Short for marshmallow. My little marshmallow. This way, please.
To and including yesterday, our sales have increased 55%.
I smell smoke.
Mr. Luffler, I know it's hurt your feelings,
right,
but as a merchandise
Sam.
Man, I must say that a 55% jump in sales is quite a painkiller.
I'll think it over.
You call for me, Mr. Luffler?
Yes. I can always get them back. For the credit department.
Oh, yes, sir.
Joey, you're a smart lad. Do you think I acted hasty in the firing?
If it were my product, I wouldn't let anybody ridicule
it. Mr.
Luffler,
your wife on one.
Yes, dear. Would you mind your own business, dear? And would you tell the Ladies' Garden Club to mind its own business?
For the credit department, get me Browning, Schlegel, and McNally in New York City right away. Now, don't worry, it's kosher. Mr. Luffler gave me a message for them.
You know the number?
It's the biggest advertising agency in New York. Browning, Schlegel, and McNally. A trying information, huh?
Browning, Schlegel, and McNally. Long distance from Memphis. Just a moment. A Mr. Joseph DePalma from Memphis. He represents Lonesome Roads.
Don't you know what a crazy business we're in? This is about some joker called Lonesome Roads on a local Memphis state. Hey, you top of CBS and NBC down there. Hello? Mr. DePalma?
Hello. I just thought I ought to let you know that Lonesome Roads is being flooded with offers. Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah, if you happen to be interested, 5 o'clock is our deadline. Uh-huh. All right. I'll call you back at 5.
Fine. Well, bless you, baby.
You know, I quit that show on my vacation. He's a living doll.
Well, could be. EBDNO in New York City.
Marcia! Marcia! Marcia, you told me to pick you up in time for the show.
Oh, hey, hey, have you seen Lonesome? You
may find him in there.
Where, here? Oh, you mean in here?
Wait a minute, sir. I wouldn't barge in there if I were you.
I'm not you. Hey, hey, Lonesome! Lonesome, boy! Hey!
Yeah, yeah. Who is it?
It's Destiny. That's who it is. Joe Destiny.
Who is it?
Hi.
What the? What,
and a child, I sold your show.
To who?
To the big time. You ever hear of Browning, Schlegel, and McNally? No, you wouldn't know. The advertising company. Boy, I got them bidding against the Kuttner Agency, MCA...
MC who?
And about a dozen others you wouldn't know. Now look. BS&M wants you for the Vitajex hour. 8 o'clock, coast to coast. I told them we'd let them know at 1700 hours. Boy, I tell you, we're on to New York.
We are?
They asked me if you had a New York agent. Would you like to meet your New York agent?
A bum out of jail in Pickett, Arkansas, and a Memphis office boy. Hey, I'm a roving
gang.
Ramble all around.
Yahoo!
Whenever I see a deck card, I lay my money down.
Around. Jump, baby.
Whenever I see a deck
yes,
card,
sir.
I lay my
Talk
money
daddy
down.
Off.
Well, I lay my money down. Oh, do down.
Hey, will you sign this?
Hey, oh, yes, I'll sign.
You? Oh, thank you. Now, in the last quarter, gentlemen, and Miss Valerie, we have spent over $300,000 of General Haynesworth's money to make this country Vitajex conscious. And all we've succeeded in doing, next chart, please, is dropping from 10% of the market to 7%. Now, I,
Mr. Macy, I'm late for the dog food meeting now. Can I say my say and go?
Yes, Doctor.
Miss, now I've gone over this product pretty carefully in the lab. Vitajex has a few grains of aspirin, a little sugar that might give you some energy, but, well, frankly, general or no general, we have nothing to sell.
Will you strike that from the transcript, Miss Murray? You know that General Haynesworth always reads the product group reports.
I can't help it. I was hired as a research chemist.
Dr. Wiley, there's nothing wrong with Vitajex, is there?
It won't kill you, if that's what you mean. I'd say it's relatively harmless, like a lot of the old patent
medicine. Thank you, Doctor. Now, let's get this train back on the tracks.
Miss Mills.
With all due respect to our estimable television department...
It's our guts.
And its sudden enthusiasm for Lonesome Roads, I think we need a dignified cell. I'd like to see a 15-minute participation on the Ed Murrow Show.
Mr. Rhodes is here, sir.
Jim, boy, don't you think it's a regular.
Well, I just thought if you and the boys got a look at him, they should see why the TV shop is sold on him.
Gentlemen, Lonesome Rhodes.
Hi, folks. Howdy. Come to help you sell these little kidney pills, whatever the heck they are. Hey, what's the matter? You got no spittoons around here?
Denise, would you bring the gentleman a spittoon?
Now, what's your particular problem, Mr. Fuzzy Lip?
Sit down, Mr. Rhodes.
You may as well know, Vida Jax is the sixth sister in the international drug family. They're even getting ready to put out a smaller pill and to cut the...
Jimboy, before we make any hasty decisions, I reckon...
Can you look at these poor little white pills you're trying to peddle? Look kind of pale. And no charge to them. Yeah, I got an idea. Let's make them yellow. Yellow's the color of sunshine and energy. Gives a fella that get up and go, it sets him up solid with the ladies. You get the idea? Like this, if you want to be bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, why, just gobble up a handful of Vita Jax and your battery's charged. Watch. Personality undergoes a startling change. Oh, I'm gonna get you, you red-headed bloody you. That's what Vita Jax does to me, and I ain't even swallowed them yet. You college geniuses want dignity on your program. Back where I come from, if a fella looks too dignified, we figure he's looking to steal your watch. I'll move your merchandise.
He's not exactly General Hansworth.
Yeah, hey,
Shh.
Peace. Peace. Oh, Vita Jax, what you doing to me? Oh, Vita Jax, what you doing to me? You fill me full of ecstasy. Oh, Vita Jax, what you doing to me?
Yeah.
Oh, Vita Jax.
Vita Jax, what you doing to me? Vita Jax, what you doing to me? You fill me full of woo and ecstasy. Vita Jax.
Contains 97 units of energy-giving Endrogaine.
Keep your eye on that rating.
That's why Vita Jax gives you that get up and go.
Do you have trouble with your girl? Does she look elsewhere? Here's how Vita Pig solved his problem.
This is General Hainsworth. I've just seen Lonesome, what's his name, on the television, and I like him.
Why don't you take Vita Jax like Lonesome Roadster?
She's talking about the new large economy size.
I bought my boyfriend a 10-year supply.
And now, the soft cell. Keep
Oom.
Your eye on the rating.
Vita Jax, Vita Jax, Vita Jax.
Vita Jax, what you're doing to me?
Now, the hard cell.
Vita Jax, 39.8.
General, I'm willing to put myself on record. I say he's a risk. Uncooperative and unpredictable. Why, we've spent tens of thousands of dollars to find out the key words like bracing and zestful. Rhodes has the audacity to tear our copy to shreds right in front of the audience.
39.8. Hey, General, what have I got?
General, if you'll forgive us, we have to get back to town.
Why, hello, girls! How's Princeton 28 and old 8 to the stump?
Afraid I make East Madison Avenue fellas kind of unhappy.
Well, I'm not in the business to make those fellas happy. I'm in the business of putting the public in a frame of mind to buy VitaJax.
Exactly.
Excuse us, dear.
Of course.
Poor old Mace. He's already had one heart attack, and I'm afraid you're winding him up to another one.
Well, General, that's his hard luck.
Hello, Senator. Did you have a fine flight?
Splendid. Splendid. I'll join you when I get freshened up a bit.
That's my house guest, Senator Fuller. That's the sort of man I like to see in the White House.
Don't they call him the last of the isolationists?
Oh, maybe in some of those left-wing New York papers. Rhodes, I want you to get to know people like that. I'd like to sort of take you under my wing and educate you.
Sure, General. I'm just a country boy.
Young man, never forget Will Rogers. He was just a gum-chewing, rope-twirling cowboy. But he got to where he was telling off presidents and kings.
General, my thinking is the second section of the same train.
I've always gone in for long-range planning. Right now, Lonesome is merely popular. Oh, very popular. But Lonesome Rhodes could be made into an influence, a wielder of opinion, an institution positively sacred to this country, like the Washington Monument. I suspect your idealistic young lady disagrees with me. But my study of history has convinced me that in every strong and healthy society, from the Egyptians on, the mass had to be guided with a strong hand by a responsible elite. Let us not forget that in TV we have the greatest instrument for mass persuasion in the history of the world.
General, I don't mean to flatter you, sir, but what...
Oh, yes. Well, let's have a go at it, shall we? Roger. Roger! Are you jotting this down? First, I'll see if I can sell Henry on the idea of a life cover. Remind me to call him for lunch.
I proudly dedicate to you the latest hybrid iris of our horticultural laboratory, the Unis Praoetorum. We girls call it the Lonesome Rhodes.
I christen thee the USS Rhodes! And so, in behalf of our great Commonwealth, I'm proud to dedicate one of nature's wonders, henceforth and forever to be known as Mount Rhodes.
And now, Lonesome, back in those difficult days, you had a pal. We flew him to New York tonight to help recall the struggle and joys of times gone by, because Lonesome Rhodes, you lived it!
Oops. Hey, Lonesome!
Beat it! You're the scoundrel. Where you been, anyhow, huh? Here, go out and get you some good-looking clothes. You've been looking ugly about as long as I can stand it. White Plains, New York. Thank you. Yeah. Hey, listen to this. Dear Lonesome, the boys in our ward at the Veterans Hospital just got together and donated $9.75. You ask me how I can keep going 17 hours without sleep? Man, this is better than sleep. Didn't I tell you, kid? Didn't I tell you?
You still want me to hold this guy?
As general manager of the Sherry Towers, it's my honor to present you with a gold key to the two top floors of New York's finest hotel.
To the very top, boy.
Yeah, you can't go much higher than that, kid.
Oh. Hello. Oh, Larry. Oh, what time is it?
Marcia, you gotta come over. I never should have let Joy sell me on the idea of living in a penthouse over the offices. 25 rooms to be alone in. I feel like a shipwrecked fellow on an island.
Oh, Larry, I know that island. It's populated by a tribe of friendly girls.
Marcia, honey, do you believe me when I say it's a matter of life and death?
Call me soon, doll.
Huh? Larry?
If you don't come, I'll dive off this balcony into the park, and I'm 10 blocks from the lake.
Marcia, come out here a minute.
I had a girl up here tonight. Are you restless? Well, I'll lie to you. When it's over, I'm more lonely than I was before. Marcia, will you come out here a minute? Look at all them TV arrows sticking up like branches down there. There's a whole forest out here to San Diego. Oh, I'm waiting to hear what I got to say.
Is that what you woke me up in the middle of the night for?
Marcia, what I'm trying to say is all the millions of people believing in me, doing what I tell them to, scares me. Honest, the general and all them big shots trying to educate me.
Educate you or use you?
That's it. See, the general says our country needs me. I'm supposed to be an influence. Mighty tall grass, Marcia. We're getting in deep, Marcia.
A thousand times deeper than we ever dreamed when we were starting out in Arkansas.
I know on the set I'm beginning to act like I just ate the Western Hemisphere for breakfast, but I'm down here in the boiler room. I know I need advice. Not the kind I get from Joey.
Now, the Madison Avenue High Dome, say, zoom tight before I even pucker up the sneeze.
No, right now when I'm coming to the top of the mountain, I need you. Because you level with me. You're my lifeline to truth. And... well, marry me, Marsh. Will you? That's what I called you over here for. Can't keep anything alive up here. Dust in this city kills everything.
So she got a dress on.
I don't want to see anybody up here.
Okay, I'll tell her to pick it up and move it out.
I'm sorry, ma'am.
You know, some of you trade in your old cars because
are you the
flashy new model catches your eye.
I am Mrs. Rose.
Well, fellas, you can't treat your wife. Help me.
You related to Mr. Rose?
Love and cherish like she was a used car. Like you take my mom and
but you're
dad
not his,
married 50
his mother.
Years. Golden wedding anniversary last month. And
his
that's still holding hands. Still spooning, if you please.
All right, Beanie.
You know, the other day I was talking about divorce and telling any good people like that what you think about it. Just try a little harder to see the other side of the argument.
And he's something.
Never leave a first love just to have the last word. That's a lonesome.
Oh,
done?
Only thing I know about, 5,000 letters come in.
Oh.
Your lonesome's new tootsie, huh? Lonesome. It's a hot one. I hope you have better luck keeping them lonesome than I did.
I think you should understand that I'm just a business associate of Mr. Rhodes.
Ain't you the whole boxed up, though? The floor manager of your program is my brother-in-law's first cousin. He told me where I could find you. So you come off it, little lady. You mind if I do? I'm through with it.
I must say, I think Mr. Rhodes might have done me the courtesy of telling me himself.
Oh, Mr. Rhodes don't do no courtesies to nobody. I could write a book about him.
Is that the purpose of your visit, to collect some more material?
Oh, I came to collect. But it ain't material. Unless you get Larry to pay me $3,000 a month, not only will I not divorce him, but I will make it plenty hot for the both of you. I already got some feelers from Confidential Magazine.
I'm not engaged to your husband.
Larry, he thinks he has to take a bite out of every broad he comes across. Then he calls him a tramp, and he drops him, and it's all sort of psycho something or other, you know? I caught him red-handed with my best girlfriend. He broke my jaw.
Seems to be working quite effectively now.
Mm-hmm.
Mrs. Rhodes, if you'll excuse me, I'm very busy this morning.
Oh, sir.
Well, tell Larry, 3G a month, and he's yours.
Two nice kids live happily ever after now. If you don't, Uncle Lonesome will come out and knock your heads together. Boy, got your boy to nothing. Happy second honeymoon, Oscar and Wilma.
An old-fashioned marriage is my kind of marriage. It's a sincere type song. Should be a big hit.
An old-fashioned church, an old-fashioned kiss. Neath the silver.
Oh, shut up.
Friendly greeting, Sunday go to meeting. Just plain folks. Bible reading, pork chop feeding. Just plain folks. Stew on the table, mule in the stable.
These are our barefoot burials. They're rehearsing our new theme song.
Very catchy.
One's from Kiss Road.
Well, actually, those two fellows over there wrote it. Of course, their names aren't on.
Well, General, we wanted to show you this. A Lonesome Rhodes designed it himself, a reaction machine. You just push these little levers here, it can laugh. Giggle.
Ain't that a booger, General?
Most ingenious.
We're thinking of putting them on the market. The Lonesome Rhodes Automatic Reactor.
Mechanical laughter, mechanical applause. What are we coming to?
We're coming to a bigger model. That's what we're coming to.
I'm sorry to end this visit. Been most interesting. But I've got a date at my club. Lunch with Senator Fuller.
What's the matter with you today? General, I wish you had time to see our whole operation. The various departments,
Marsha, you aren't tying a clock this morning. What's the matter?
Next time you propose to somebody, you might consider getting unmarried first.
Listen, Deanie told me. It ain't as bad as you think. See, I got a divorce a couple years ago in Mexico, but the judge got indicted for fraud, so my ex claimed that the
divorce... Here are the latest ratings, Mr. Rhodes.
Ooh, hallelujah! Rhodes 41.4, opposition 19.5. Boy, that other fellow's gonna be jumping out of windows. Oh, so, like I say, the ex claimed the divorce was a fraud, too. I got a good lawyer working it out for me in Juarez. He said if I come down there, he'd get off my back in 24 hours.
Larry, don't play with me. I'm not one of your girls.
On a stack of Bibles, Marshy. Look, Saturday I'm going to be down in Pickett judging the Arkansas Drum Majorette contest. I'll go straight from there to Mexico. The next time you hear from me, it'll be from Juarez. Believe me.
dreadful. That is just dreadful.
While you wait, we also take in laundry. Yeah, that's a new one.
Hey, welcome to the black hole of Calcutta.
Oh, this is one place they didn't show the general.
Naturally, here you see the lepers of the great television industry, men without faces. Why, they even slide our paychecks under the door so they can pretend we're not here.
Ha, ha, ha.
But think of the satisfaction of being even a small cog in the great wheel of humanity known as Lonesome Roads.
Ha, ha, ha. Get her. Sounds like she's coming over to our side.
Ha, ha, ha. Why don't you quit?
Why don't you quit?
Because I'm deeply involved with him.
Spoken like a lady.
You got his introduction ready?
The hometown boy, not only making good, but making everybody.
Well, for a mild man, you sound vicious.
Didn't you know? All mild men are vicious. They hate themselves for being mild, and they hate the windy extroverts whose violence seems to have a strange attraction for nice girls who should know better. Today, a face in the crowd takes you on a sentimental journey. As Lonesome Roads, your old Arkansas traveler goes home to the typical dirt road, cotton-picking town, of Piggott, Arkansas.
Where America's favorite country cousin first got his humble start, and where he now returns to the simple folks who saw and loved him first, to choose as his latest face in the crowd the lucky and talented girl whom he will select from hundreds of contestants as Miss Arkansas Drum Majorette of 1957. And here is the man you've been waiting for. Here he is.
Look at him. Look at him. Ain't that the most? Country people, the heart of America, the south of the earth. Hey, baby, baby, Ella. We love Ella. Hi, you all.
Dangerous.
What, baton twirling?
Power. You gotta be a saint to stand off the power that little box can give you.
Oh,
it's wonderful.
Al vivo! Al vivo! Al vivo, babo, bum! Bum, get a red chip, bigger than ketchup! Bum, get a red chip, bigger than ketchup!
She looks like a very sweet child.
This fine representative body of wholesome young American womanhood. You know, I've been a fan of baton twirling from way back. I think it's an honest to God American art form.
Here's a little number I just wrote and recorded for the Gold Note label. Thought you kids might enjoy twirling to it. Here she goes, Mama Guitar! Oh, yeah. First contestant will be Miss Suzanne McKinley of Beaglestown. Let's have a real doozy, Susie.
Mama, Mama Guitar. I love my Mama Guitar. My Mama Guitar makes a woman every time. My Mama Guitar makes a woman every time.
And now Miss Linda Bruce from Ganderstown. Old girl, go!
Mama Guitar makes a woman every time.
I give you Miss Mary Jane Johnson from the neighboring village of Pocahontas.
Sang out sweet or blue. And if her strings get rusty, you can trade her in for new.
A mama guitar beats a woman every time. Hey, mama.
Mama guitar.
Hey, mama guitar. Sweet mama, mama guitar. I love my mama. I love my mama. I love my mama. I love my mama. I love, 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 love.
And I say that the winner by unanimous decision, and that's me, is Little Miss Betty Lou Flecker, Miss Arkansas from Edgewood of 1957.
Pasted your picture on the ceiling over my bed. So you're the first thing I see when I wake up in the morning.
Well, bless your heart.
All right.
What are you going to have, Seth?
I'm going to make mine look. Yes, I have a family
think it
show.
Went rather well. Oh, thanks.
Nice. Good show, Dad.
Yes, I think it had size. Hi, Burl. Didn't you?
Face that baton bit was the living end.
Thanks, Betty. As Lonesome said, it's an American art form.
Less water, Joe.
Oh. Feature for show, Miss Jeffries.
Thanks.
Should boost the rating.
Poor Maisie.
Lives on a diet of nitroglycerin and Trundex rating. Call it a Bible, but it's really a death warrant with decimal points.
There, there. Well,
yes, sir.
Hi.
Thanks for the drink, sir.
Oh, Miss J, just came.
You know, there's one thing about being in this place, it's just like being in the office.
Not quite. Joe, two more, please. And this time, would you just let the vermouth blow a kiss at the gym?
I'm a barefoot boy. Won't be flying in tonight.
hopping over to Juarez. See if you can get Arthur Godfrey to fill in for me. Tell him I'll do the same for him someday. Counting on you to hold the fort. Boy, this shoulder's getting a permanent callus from holding that fort.
What's in Juarez?
Bars. Lawyers. Quick marriages. Quick divorces.
And this is it? You're blushing.
These 60-to-1 martinis.
I suppose I should be a gentleman and wish you all the happiness. I think I'll just be a cat and hope he chokes on a Vitajex pill.
Arkansas sweet potato, Benny Lou. I ain't been so happy since the day I fell into Grandpa Bascom's hog head of corn liquor and just guzzled my way down to dryland. I don't reckon I'll be a free man tomorrow morning, but if this ain't freedom, man, it's the next best thing. See what first caught my eye?
And what second caught my eye? And what keeps on and on catching my eye? Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Mrs. Lonesome Rose doing her unbelievable double fire baton twirling dance to the Scherzo from the Seventh Symphony by Ludwig von Beethoven.
Mr. Rhodes, could I talk to you for just a few minutes, please?
I told you I didn't want you agency jokers nagging around me on this program.
This is desperately important. Mr. Rhodes, I've been with Browning, Slagle, and McNally for 17 years in full charge of the International Drug Account. And the general just told me that he's taking his business away. Your young Mr. De Palma has wormed his way in.
Look, Macy, Joe De Palma's doing one heck of a job for me.
But you know, this business, it's cutthroat.
If a
rating nosedives or if you lose a client, even if it isn't your fault, the account executive is the code. Mr. Rhodes, if I lose this account, I'll be fired. I've got a son in Princeton. Mr. Rhodes, you've seen my office, a corner office with four windows. Do you know how long it takes Browning, Slagle, and McNally to get a corner?
I was afraid to marry you, and that's the truth. The dirt root, cotton picking truth.
Last time you said you were afraid not to.
Both were true. You sort of overawe me. You know more than I do, and I can feel you being so gall darn critical all the time. You and that smart alecky Mel. You don't really approve of me, that's so, ain't it?
You're getting to be all the things you used to harpoon.
See what I mean? The bigger I get, the smaller you make me feel. You take Betty Lou.
Harry, don't try to explain. Betty Lou is your public, all wrapped up with yellow ribbons into one cute little package. She's the logical culmination of the great 20th century love affair between Lonesome Rhodes and his mass audience.
Well, I wish you wasn't so bitter.
I'm not bitter. I sound stridently female about Miss Drum, Majorette. I don't mean to be. I knew you married her just as a way of not marrying me.
Look, Marsha. I'm not forgetting what I owe you. I'm gonna give you a healthy slice of our whole operation. Say, 10% of my end, and you won't have to lift your finger with what I'm giving you.
Giving me? Giving me? You're not giving me anything. And you're not throwing me off the train like poor Abe Steiner, either. Facing the crowd was my idea. The whole idea of Lonesome Rhodes belongs to me. I always should have been an equal partner. Well, now I'm gonna be an equal partner. I'm gonna get something I deserve.
Don't sound like you, Marsha.
And I want it on paper.
Okay. All right. I'll tell Joey to draw up the papers. Put yourself in the mirror, Marsha. You'll see a millionaire. It's always Vanderbilt 44.
Going back to Memphis, I think he wants to forget us both.
I thought he'd wait for you till there was ice on the equator.
That's how long he did wait.
When newspaper people ask me, Walter, where do you get all that news? I invariably tell them I usually get it from an awful lot of people who promise somebody else they'd keep it a secret. As for example, just what is Lonesome Rhodes going to talk to General Haynesworth about? Oh, General. Oh, Lonesome Rhodes.
And now, Mike Wallace interviews Senator Worthington Fuller.
Senator Fuller, then you mean to tell me, sir, that you are not infected with the presidential itch?
Itch?
Senator, is it not a fact that you have a date tomorrow night for what is known as Madison Avenue coaching from Lonesome Rhodes in General Haynesworth's private projection room?
I have said it calls for the closest scrutiny. I am unable to persuade myself and to believe that in the belief that flagrant squandering of American wealth at home and abroad is the road to a sound peace. Thank you all, and good evening all.
Lights!
I know that's not what the American people want to hear, but I think I know what's best for them.
We think so, too. That's why everyone in this room wants you to be the next president of the United States. But your problem is getting the voters to listen to you, getting them to like you enough to listen to you. Senator, I've got to be blunt. Your TV appearances have been, well, catastrophes. Wouldn't you say so, Lonesome?
By the way, Beanie, I asked you to check the ratings when the senator was on Face the People.
Brutal. No, excuse me, 4.2.
Go right ahead, General.
We've got to face it. Politics have entered a new stage, the television stage. Instead of long-winded public debates, the people want caps or slogans. Time for a change, the mess in Washington, more bang for a buck, punchlines and glamour. Yes, Mr. Purvis, even glamour.
General Haynesworth, my papers have supported Worthington Fuller from the first day he ran for public office. He's not a grandstander, a backslapper, or a baby kisser.
That's exactly what he's got to become. A majority in this country don't see eye to eye with him. We've got to find 35 million buyers for the product we call Worthington Fuller.
I think you underestimate the respect which people
respect?
Are never...
Respect? Did you ever hear of anyone buying any product? Beer, hair rinse, tissue, because they respect it? You gotta be loved, man. Loved!
Well, I may be a bit old-fashioned, but it seems to me there is still a distinction between politics and, well, the field you're in.
Bull.
I beg your pardon, sir.
Sorry if I tread on your corns, but I said bull. Politics is people.
Mr. Rhodes!
Now, look, the general asked me to cut my rehearsal short to come down here. If you don't want to hear my thinking...
Do go on, Mr. Rhodes.
I'm sorry to make a disturbance, but General... Oh,
Senator, I'm a professional, sir. Sit down, relax. And I have to look at the image on that screen same as I'd look at a performer on my show. And I'll have to say, he'll never get over to my audience. Not to the 65 million people who welcome me into their living rooms each week. And if I wouldn't buy him, do you realize what that means? If I wouldn't buy him, the people of this country aren't ready to buy him for that big job on Pennsylvania Avenue. Look, I got a fella here. You know where I found him? I don't think he'll mind my saying it. In jail. He's stupid. He's got no mentality. He thinks with his feet. But I trust those feet. Now, if he don't laugh, if he don't think the show is any good, then I know there's something wrong with it. Something people just ain't a-gonna take to. You see what I mean? Now, Beanie, what did you think of the personality you just saw on the screen?
Well, I,
Come on. Give it to us straight.
Flatter than last night's beer.
You see your problem now, Senator? How are you gonna get this man, this bush monkey, to vote for you?
Frankly, I don't know.
Well, maybe I do. Do you know what you need to lift your rating from 4.2 to 51.7? You need, now hold on to your hat, my friend. You need a whole new personality.
A new personality? Well, frankly, that's impossible.
Now wait just a moment. For instance, do you have a pet?
My wife and I have a Siamese cat.
Beanie? My public love dogs. One pitch with a hound is worth 10,000 words. That mutt didn't do Roosevelt any harm, did it? Dick Nixon either.
No, I'm sure you're right.
How about a nickname? Only dishonest thing about Curly Fuller is the way he combs his hat.
Curly.
That's rather amusing.
See? Shows you got a sense of humor about that fine head of skin you got there. No hard feelings now. We're talking television. Don't press your lips together so much. Gives you a kind of a sissy look. Keep your mouth relaxed so you can say... Once in a while. Sounds sort of crazy to you, doesn't it?
No, I realize it's a new technique and I've got to face it. That's why I came.
Good.
That's a boy, Curly. You just put yourself in my hands. I'll have him loving him. I mean loving him.
You know, that's just what he did for Vita Jax.
He ought to be in the cabinet.
I'll be going to bed now, sir.
Good night, Sidney. Lonesome, I don't know anyone in the country who could have won the senator the way you did tonight. It was a brilliant...
Shut up, will you? I'm thinking.
Lonesome, listen to me as your adopted father. You have only one flaw, the way you've begun to suddenly shoot out of control. Like this evening, almost walking out on the senator. And you're beginning to antagonize the press. You're great.
Cracker Barrel. Lonesome Rhodes Cracker Barrel.
What's that?
My new show. Won't you set it up for me right away? Get me a whole bunch of colorful country-looking characters all sitting around, listening to Lonesome Rhodes sound off about everything from the price of popcorn to the hydrogen bomb. You don't like it? Well, just forget it. All I've got to do is pick up the phone and I can get Tim Andrews of National Motors to back it for me in a minute. I'm not just an entertainer. I'm an influence, a wielder of opinion. A force. A force.
And now Shelton Cigarettes, Best Friend Dog Food, and Vita Jax bring you the voice of grassroot wisdom. Lonesome Rhodes on the Cracker Barrel.
You know, boys, what really bugs me about our limey cousins is the way they keep on trying to act like a first-class outfit when their store is having to close up its branches all over the world.
That's telling them.
He's getting more global every minute.
That's the Lord's truth.
Well, look who's stopping by to chew the fat with us around the old Cracker Barrel. Senator Worthington Fuller. Hey, howdy, Curly. How's my old bunkmate? Fine. It's a real pleasant surprise. Come on in and meet the boys.
Hello, man.
Sit down here on the Cracker Barrel and get your feet up on the stove back. That's a boy. Now you look at home. Well, here we are. All set for a real old...
Hello, Mr. Miller. Long time no see. It's usual. Yeah. Wake
up, Barbara. Just let the vermouth blow a kiss at the gin.
Yes, sir. In just a little while, I'm going to be talking some questions at old Curly Fuller here. I should say, Senator Worthington Fuller. Senator, I got...
You waiting for someone?
I'm just having a quiet drink.
I don't remember you doing that before. You know, back
in my little old... Well, I talk to 1,000 people a day. This gives me a chance to unwind.
You got from guzzling too much raw whiskey. We didn't know
that swallowing too much raw politics can put a crease in your head a whole lot deeper than that homemade Kickapoo jaw juice that we used to concoct back in Arkansas. I wish you'd give me the real cotton-picking truth about how you feel on the subject of more and more and more Social Security.
I'm glad you asked me that question, Lonesome. I'd say that people today are obsessed.
Huh?
I mean, real gone for security. They want protection, coddling, from the cradle to the grave. I say that weakens the moral fiber. Why, Daniel Boone wasn't looking for unemployment insurance and old age pension. All he needed was his axe and his gun and a chance to hew a living out of the forest with his own hands.
Real woodsy, ain't he?
That's telling him, Senator. You heard one that time.
That's the spirit that built this country.
Joe, would you turn that sound down a little bit, please?
Not big government.
I say one thing for him. He's got the courage of his ignorance.
Well, how's our old station in Memphis?
I didn't go near it. I've been writing a book about... I call it Demagogue in Denim. Never had such a good time in my life.
Well, you look wonderful.
All those months he was calling me Vanderbilt 44 and frontal lobe. And I should have been punching him in the nose. Well, now I got the book to punch him in the nose.
It's gonna be published?
Came up to sign the contracts. Publishers are real high on it. They think the time is right to pull a mask off him. Let the public see what a fraud he really is.
Well, I wouldn't say that.
What would you say?
Well, it's just that it's harder for him to be as simple as he was with all those generals and senators and political big shots hanging around him all the time.
You're still with him?
Well, at least I toned down some of the crazier notions he wants to spout on the air, and I seem to be the only person he can talk to anymore. Keep a lot of people from getting fired, and... Well, there's an awful lot of money at stake. Our agency, the one we started with, International Drug Account, is doing a gross business over $100 million a year.
And how the mama guitar selling?
Mm. Well, I found him. He's mine for better or worse, and I keep doing my small bit to make him better.
Marsha, you know what you are? You're the locker room where he eases up after the fight, win or lose. You're the shock absorber for collisions with ex-wives and models and new wives and assorted tramps. You're the little wheel of efficiency without which a great streamlined express called Lonesome Roads plunges off the track and leaps to destruction.
I can hardly wait to read that book.
Don't you worry. I've spared you more than you've spared yourself.
I know.
I'll call you again sometime when I think you're ready.
Hey, Betty Lou! Take a look at this Gallup poll. I got Curly up from 3% of the voters to 11. 11! That's a lucky number he's gonna be in. Hey, sweet patootie! Look who's home, you big papa man!
You're not going to hit me. Don't play the noble defender of the sanctity of marriage with me, Papa Man. I know where you've been some of those nights when Betty was waiting up for you. Well, you hit me and it'll be all over the papers. As much as the people love you tonight, they can hate
you're
you in the
fired.
Morning.
You're through with Lonesome Roads.
I've got news that'll move you and shake you. I'm president of Lonesome Roads Enterprises. I own 51% of the voting stock. You're in bed with me, Larry.
in bed.
Give me Beanie.
I think I'll just freshen up my soda.
Beanie, get Ms. Rose a brunette on the next train to Little Rock. You don't own 51% of the stock. You're fired.
Fired? Lonesome. Lonesome, nothing happened, really.
This program is being brought to you by Shelton Cigarettes.
And ooh.
I won't treat you like any performer on my show that flops. I got a contract with you. You'll get your money every week as long as you stay in Arkansas.
But I don't want to go home. Besides, Ed Sullivan wants me to do my double fire baton dance on his show Sunday night.
You can do your double fire baton twirling dance in the ladies' room of the Little Rock Depot.
Flusy, she'd have ruined me. That's what she'd have done. Make me a drink.
What are you doing?
We'll have to be more careful than we used to be. We'll have to stay married till I get my new appointment.
Your what?
This is still top secret. The general's been talking to Fuller. He's selling him on the idea of creating a new cabinet post for me. In time of imminent crisis and danger. That's the way the general puts it. Who could rally the people better than I could? Hold them in line right behind the government. If we'd put Fuller across the way, I know we're gonna. He's gonna owe me that. Secretary for National Morale. How's that sound to you, Marcia? Secretary for National Morale. General's asking Fuller to shake hands on it with me after the big banquet I'm throwing tomorrow night, launching Fighters for Fuller.
Fighters for Fuller?
Yeah, Fighters for Fuller. How you like that name, huh? I made it up. Everybody's nuts about it. I got 20 of the biggest men in this country coming to my banquet tomorrow night to get Fighters for Fuller rolling. Got a retired admiral from the Joint Chiefs, two governors, some of them big investment house boys, and a cabinet minister.
Which one?
I don't know. I told the general to pick one out for me.
And they're coming to your party.
Oh, honey, if I ask them, they gotta come. Maybe they'd be afraid not to come. I could murder them, like this.
I'm afraid it's true.
What's true?
Right here tonight, you might have that much power.
In your ratings this morning? 53.7. Just picked up another million. This whole country's just like my flock of sheep.
Sheep?
Rednecks, crackers, hillbillies, housefrouws, shut-ins, pea-pickers. Everybody that's got to jump when somebody else blows the whistle. They don't know it yet, but they're all gonna be Fighters for Fuller. They're mine. I own them. They think like I do. Only they're even more stupid than I am, so I gotta think for them. Marsha, you just wait and see. I'm gonna be the power behind the president, and you'll be the power behind me.
You made me, Marsha. You made me. I always say that. I owe it all to you. I owe it all to you. All to you.
So I know it. I know it. I know it.
Yes.
Come on, I got to get some sleep.
Marsha! Marsha, where are you going?
Say is tonight's show is gonna be a mess.
Now you tell me the show's in a mess. Now you tell me.
Yes, but you see, Marsha never showed up all day. And she's the only one who can coordinate.
Coordinate hell! Do you mean to tell me the success of my show depends on one self-important, neurotic, temperamental female? I'm fed up with a whole lot of you incompetents, nincompoops, bootlickers.
Would you like some hot coffee, Mr. Rhodes?
Is that your subtle way of trying to tell me I'm swacked? Well, I'm not drunk, just disgusted. Okay, I'll handle it.
Of course you will, Mr.
Ad lib. Just keep up with me.
I've saved the show before.
Well, I just wonder what they do with their afternoons. Wives and all.
One more day like this and I...
Here she comes now.
Our lady is too busy.
Marsha, where have you been? I've been trying to find you all day. Take two.
You know how important that is.
Mr. Collier, we still haven't got our commercials routine.
Take three.
I know that's kind of gone out of style, like the corset.
But every once in a while I ask myself, lonesome, where's that unmodern, uncomplicated, unliberated, but oh, so happy, one man, woman gone.
Nah. Ain't no use getting ourselves all head up about something we can't change. Curly and I was out duck shooting over the weekend. Brought my little movie camera along to show you folks what it was like.
Roll the film.
Roll film.
Hit it.
Hey, you lunkheads up there in the projection room, show us the movie.
You're off the air, Mr. Rhodes. They can't hear you.
Get in.
About time. I want to talk to you.
I can't tonight because I got to rush over to the bank. But first thing in the morning.
In my office, in the morning.
20 seconds, Mr. Rhodes, 20 seconds.
Who can take this? I quit today.
A half mile away. Well, even after the senator bagged his limit, how he hated to leave that blind. He says to me, says, lonesome.
You keep the door clear. It's run by a lot of dim-witted sons of Nippling.
Hey, you redneck scoundrel still here? Why ain't you out working someplace? Ain't that Curly Fuller a duck-shooting fool? You know, when we're standing there, shoulder to shoulder in that cold water, belly button high, and the sun has come in and smile in on us, Curly looked at me and he says, lonesome,
the family that prays together stays together.
That's the truth.
That's what he said.
I tell you, that man is an inspiration. A man among men.
The Cracker Barrel, starring that irrepressible Arkansas traveler.
You're off.
Glad that's over. I'm gonna start shooting people instead of ducks.
For relaxation and for health. The cigarette that cleans your tobacco without a filter. And by Best Friend Dog Food.
Take one.
Your dog's
change
best
two.
Friend. And by Vitajex. That old Vitajex Whatcha Doin' to Me pill.
Well, hurry back, you all. Remember what old Uncle Lonesome said. The family that prays together stays together.
All right, Super One, and start the crawl.
This has been an FPN production.
Full of the great Hunter. He's shaking like this.
Oh, if they ever heard the way that psycho really talks.
Choreography, Don Krantz. Scenic design, James Fitzsimmons. Costumes by Robert Hose. Unit manager, George K. George.
This is really sell that stiff as a man among men?
Are those morons out there?
Yeah.
I can take chicken fertilizer instead of doing some caviar. I can make them eat dog food and they'll think it's steak. Sure, I got them like this.
You know what the public's like, a cage full of guinea pigs.
Good night, you stupid idiot. Good night, you miserable slob.
They're a lot of trained seals. I toss them a dead fish and they'll flap their flippers.
Well, Jim, so close a walk with thee.
Why, he's a monster. I'm going to call the station. I'm going to give him a piece of my mind.
Well, thanks, you, Jack.
I knew he'd open his big yap once too often and blow my 3 G's.
Mr. Macy, I can hardly believe it's the same Lonesome Rhodes.
It is, only this time his personality finally came through.
Give me a drink. Gotta hurry, boys. He's a big, important date. You better come in strong tomorrow. I'll be loaded for bear. Come on, B.
Hello, elevator for you, Mr. R. The Lonesome Rhodes Express. Going down.
All the way down, lad.
Yes, sir.
Federal Broadcasting Network. That line is busy.
Well, you can just tell him from me that I'll never listen to his filthy program again.
So we're slobs, are we? Well, you can tell Lonesome Rhodes from me.
FBN.
I said, are you paying your network $100,000 an hour to build up our business or destroy it?
Now, just a minute, General.
Get the palm on the phone.
Remember, it was your advertising company that brought Lonesome Rhodes to FBN.
But to keep this candle from rubbing off on biter jacks, I mean disassociate ourselves.
Lonesome Rhodes, that line is busy.
Board's burning up. What'd he say?
I don't know, but it must have been a whopper.
Better come up fast with a good replacement.
Well, I got you down in a hurry.
Give him a blow. We're not stopping to pick up the peasants. How's your rating, Beth?
No, I'm sorry. Mr. Rhodes has left for the day. No, I'm sorry. There's no one in the studio.
That's right, DePalma. You know your contract, the morals clause. Any act abusing public confidence.
I think I've got just the boy to fill the gap. Yeah, Barry Mills. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's a young Lonesome Rhodes and a lot easier to handle.
Team, buddy, I'm just a country boy.
Don't spare the horses. I've only got 30 minutes to get into my dinner clothes.
Hellar's blooper top sunk down.
I never see what people saw on that guy, but whatever it was, he's had it.
The sinking of the Titanic, a night to remember. What happened?
Marcia, she went, where is she? She's still in the booth.
I hear you just wrote that into my book. Yeah. Just a minute, I'll see if she's here. Tim.
I've got her, Lonesome. I've got her.
Marcia. Oh, Marcia, I need you. Come over right away. Nobody's come. Everybody canceled out. Fuller didn't even send me a wire. The general sent me a wire.
The Secretary of the Interior sent me a wire. Regret to inform you. Unavoidably detained. Unable to attend. All of a sudden, everybody's too busy.
All of a sudden, I'm poisoned. You laughing at me?
Huh? You laughing at me? You think I'm washed up, don't you? Well, same way I lost them, I'll get them back again. I'm gonna make them love me.
You're gonna love me. Say you're gonna love me. Say you're gonna love me. Yeah, you're gonna love me. You're gonna love me.
Right, you say you're gonna love me. Right, you say you're gonna love me. Say you're gonna love me. You're gonna
love me. You're gonna love me. What's your name?
Francis.
Francis. Francis. You're gonna love me. Francis. You're gonna love me. Love me. Love me. Get off. Get off. Get off. You dressed up black monkey. You turned my stomach. Get
off. Sounds like he's finally gone through the roof.
Marsha, how soon can you get here? I'm surrounded by traitors. That engineer.
Wait till I get him. I'll fire him. I'll burn him over a slow fire. Marsha!
If you don't come right away, I'll jump!
I'll jump!
Jump! Jump! Get out of my life! Get out of everybody's life! Jump! Jump! Yeah.
I don't believe you. Now, you'll be up.
Oh, Mel.
Why didn't you tell him on the phone that it was you?
It was I, too.
Let's make it harder. I think you should go up and tell him face to face before he blames it on 20 other guys. Face to face, and then maybe I'll believe you.
It's never as simple as that.
Finally, you gotta force complicated things into simple channels like this. Either you go up there and tell him it was you who did it and chop it off clean so he never comes crying to you again. Or you hold his hand, wipe his poor, perspiring brow, fan his smoldering, dampened ego so it can burst up into flames and burn.
Secretary for National Morale is a job that I was born for.
Somebody ought to send for a doctor. He's been screaming like that for 20 minutes.
In a time of crisis, who else could rally the people like Lonesome Rhodes? Who else could move the people to action like Lonesome Rhodes? You are looking at America's answer to the crying need for national...
What are you here for? He likes lots of applause.
Beat it! Just a country boy. But if the president tries to stop me, I'll flood the White House with millions of telegrams. I made him and I can break him. Yeah! Yeah, you know I can. Because the people listen to Lonesome Rhodes. Because the people love Lonesome Rhodes. Lonesome Rhodes is the people. The people is Lonesome Rhodes. Beat it. Let me hear more. Yeah, yeah. Go. Go.
Oh.
Marcia. I knew you'd come. I knew you'd come. Listen, Marcia, I lost him. But all I got to do is talk with him one more time. Yeah, I'll tell him. I'll tell him I just said that to see how many is really listening. Yeah, sure, I'll have meeting out of my hands again just like old times.
Harry, it was me.
Then I'm back on top again. First thing I do when I'm back on top, I'll get that sound man. I'll get that dirty, stinking little mechanical genius.
It was me. I held a key open. On purpose. I'm telling you this so you'll never call me again. Never again.
Okay. Okay, Marsh. Little marshmallow. Good luck. Good luck with mail. I'm alone.
Larry, I'm sorry. Forgive me.
Go on. Listen, I'm not through yet. You know what's going to happen to me?
Suppose I tell you exactly what's going to happen to you. You're going to be back in television. Only it won't be quite the same as it was before. There'll be a reasonable cooling off period, and then somebody will say, why don't we try them again in an inexpensive format? People's memories aren't too long. And you know, in a way, he'll be right. Some of the people forget, and some of them won't. Oh, you'll have a show. Maybe not the best hour, or in the top 10, maybe not even in the top 35. But you'll have a show. Just won't be quite the same as it was before. Then a couple of new fellas will come along, and pretty soon a lot of your fans will be flocking around them. And then one day somebody will ask, whatever happened to, what's his name? You know, the one who was so big. The number one fella a couple of years ago. He was famous. How can we forget a name like that? Oh, by the way, have you seen Barry Mills? I think he's the greatest thing since Will Rogers. Suicide.
Marcia!
Mel, if I'd only left him in that jail in Pickett.
Marcia, stop it. You were taken in just like we were all taken. But we get wise to him. That's our strength.
Come back,
we get wise
Marcia!
To him.